if you just run through somebody's face, a lot of people ain't gonna be able to take that over and over and over and over and over again. They just not gonna want that.
Think there's a deeper metaphor there?
Run through a motherfucking face.
To cash in on this opportunity. Everybody wanna be a beast. And turn it's time to do what beasts do. Everybody wanna be a beast. Everybody got a lion. Tattoos of lions. Lions all on their Twitter face, but everybody got the lion thing now, they tweet now. Roar. But when it's time to practice, you ain't on beast mode. When it's time to watch film, you ain't on beast mode. You ain't watching your dude. Let me say this and I'm getting out of here. Can I be real with y'all? Most of y'all think that a lion is who he is because of how ferocious he is when he catch that gazelle, when he catch that zebra. Can I be real with y'all? I want y'all to study this when y'all finish to tell me if I'm telling the truth. If a lion see an animal that's wounded, or a real hunter see an animal that's wounded, what do? They do what? They watch him, but they don't do what? They don't kill him. Why don't they kill him? He already hurt. And they beast. A part of being a beast just ain't eating a gazelle. A part of being a beast is the hunts. It's the hunt that they're excited about. They like to see the gazelles run. Then boom, they take off. Do you know that even before the gazelles get there, that the lions start listening to the gazelle? They plan and they all stop and they steal and they wait for the gazelle to come. Do you know that they take a couple lions and say, y'all go that way, and then boom, y'all chase the gazelle. Don't even eat them, just chase them and make them come this way. And when they get this way, they play games. Because real lions like to hunt. They love the process just as much as they love the prize. And some of y'all just want to score. You don't like the process. You're not in love with the process. You just like to put the pads on. You love when it's showtime. Everybody in the car, you're like, hey. Lions, see, you can't even start. You know your people there. Once you see them, you're like, showtime. A real man in the dark, when nobody's watching, he put me in work. A real man, when coach ain't even watching, he's studying film on his own. Because he loves the process. If you will be a champion, if you will be a beast, you're going to have to go through something. Ain't nobody going to hand you nothing. Ain't nobody going to hand you no championship. Ain't nobody going to hand you no title. So this is my year, I believe. This is my year. Listen to me say, be phenomenal. This is it. I want you to chant it out. This is it. Be phenomenal or be forgotten. 1, 2, 3.
Be phenomenal or be forgotten.
1, 2, 3.
Be phenomenal or be forgotten.
Last time, 1, 2, 3.
Be phenomenal or be forgotten.
That's my time, guys.
Y'all, it was called like, I could always connect with my mother's eyes, so it made me dig a little bit deeper. It made me push myself a little bit further. It made me work a little bit harder. It created a certain level of sweat equity in what I was doing. It created a certain level of pride in what I was doing. You know why people quit? People don't have pride in what they do. You know why people stop? They're selfish and it's just about them. But when you have a bigger purpose to why you're doing what you're doing and you want to honor the sacrifices that others have made for you, it's nothing for you to keep going when you hear that verse. If every decision and choice you make is just about you, at a certain point you're going to hit something that's a lot tougher than you, that's going to make you quit because you don't have a driving force for why you do what you do.
You've been double teamed, you've been triple teamed, you've been grabbed, you've been held. Give me the straight scoop. What is your status of your health right now?
I'm out there, I suit up every night. I suit up every night. Banged up, hurt, whatever. 100%, 30%, you know, numbers. It's my heart, and you can't measure that.
What's driving you? You play hard, you
then
always play hard.
And I'm losing. I'm losing. I'm losing. Man, Big John, I just don't like to lose, man. And we were sitting here playing dominoes, playing cards, running back and forth, and you kept beating. Whatever we doing, I hate to lose. I hate to lose. I don't care what it is. That's my biggest problem, is that I can't accept losing. And I won't accept losing. I won't ever accept losing. Ever. No one will ever be able to call me a loser to my face. Just stand there. You know? Never. Never.
One of the greatest pieces of advice that my mother gave me was this: son, whenever you start, you make sure you finish. And the problem with the world today, people get involved with things, and if they don't like a certain person, if they don't like the process, if it's not what they thought it was, they quit. And what they don't understand about quitting becomes a habit that doesn't just affect you. Later on in life, when you get a wife, when you get some kids, when you get a family, it's gonna come back to haunt you, and it will one day affect them. That is why I tell you the process is more important than the product. It's not even about the outcome for me. It's about, can you take pride in what you do as an individual, and every night when you look in the mirror, knowing that you gave everything you had to. And we have to get to the point where we're willing to impose our will on certain things. Impose your will on it. My life totally changed. And they gave me an opportunity to stop. And most people, when you give them an opportunity to stop while they're chasing something, they take advantage of it because they feel as if, man, why did this have to happen to me? I felt as if, why not me? This is the perfect opportunity to use this to be a blessing to somebody else. And you know what? It's not even about me, to be truthful. It's not even about me. Now it's about repaying the people that invested in me and saw something in me when I couldn't see it in myself. At a certain point in life, it can't just be about you. And the moment that we understand that, and every day we wake up, we understand that life is a blessing and life is a gift. And if you were to check out today, how would you want to be remembered? It's bigger than you.